Hi, and welcome to the 43rd episode of All Around Azure. In this episode, we'll chat with our guest, Mikolaj Shankovitz, about how to kick off your career with custom vision. But before we jump into our topic of custom vision, first let's get to know our guest, Mikolaj, and some of the projects that he's involved in.
Okay, well, first of all, thank you for having me. It's a real pleasure for me to be a guest over here. And yeah, I in order to maybe introduce myself, I even have kind of a slide. I don't know if I can show it already. I have a slide prepared.
Sure, yeah. If you're ready to start showing some slides, I can switch you over to that.
I know that's kind of narcissistic to start with a slide of my own, but hey.
That's okay.
So yeah, so I'm a computer science student from Poznan University of Technology, and Poznan, as you have mentioned, is located at Poland. It's kind of on the west side, and when you look at the longitude, is I would say in the center. So yeah, I'm right now finishing my bachelor degree. Furthermore, I'm also a DevOps engineer at a company called Cognified. And I think that this DevOps engineer is kind of a fancy name for IT engineer. So I basically make sure that our internal systems work correctly. I do some automatization. I sometimes also work with the cloud. Moreover, I'm a co-creator of Assisto Group, which I think sounds kind of mysterious right now. Uh-huh. But as I will talk a little bit later about it, I think it's going to come clear. And as you have mentioned, that you are inviting people from outside from cloud advocacy, that is the fact that I'm a Microsoft Learn Student Ambassador.
Yeah.
And maybe with this small asterisk as well, that I am also country lead for Poland, which basically means that I am coordinating work of other Microsoft Learn Student Ambassadors in our country.
Yeah.
I also put some private interests. So I'm also a hitchhiker, an avid hitchhiker.
When you were sharing these slides earlier, I was like, we've never talked about this hitchhiking stuff.
Yeah, right. Yeah.
Tell us more about that.
Yeah, unfortunately, maybe I should say that I was an avid hitchhiker, right? Yeah. Because due to pandemic, this hobby is kind of on hold. But yeah, I used to hitchhike to several places. I was in Croatia, I was in Norway. Here you can see me trying to catch somebody to Oslo, mm-hmm. or actually posing to catch somebody, to be totally honest. But yeah, I was also hitchhiking to Czech Republic, a little bit in my country as well. But well, as we all are aware of, current situation, of course, this is not an option anymore. And this is why I also have this second hobby, and I'm trying my strengths at sailing. Saying that I'm a sailor is maybe too much, because I'm not a sailor yet. I've just received my sailing license this year. And this photo is also from this year. It's during the cruise on Baltic Sea.
Later in our conversation, I asked Mikolaj, how do we get started with custom vision? He showed us the custom vision portal, as well as several cognitive services that you can demo online for free.
That's what also can happen with our machine learning models. Yeah, definitely. But if you have sufficient data and enough data, probably, and hopefully it will get it correctly with enough precision. And so, yeah, then there is the process of training. You kind of have to feed to the algorithm images that are labeled in a way, because you cannot just feed the images, because well, program will not know what it is, but you just kind of have to somehow tag it usually by saying, what do you see in this photo? And then when the algorithm somewhat learns the specific features of such objects, it can actually detect this object in the future. The way it works under the hood usually is by some image filtering. So when you feed such image, the algorithm tries out different filters. So like, just like Instagram filters, but let's say less entertaining ones. They are just kind of making those operations on images just to see which gives some maybe edges more vivid, that are actually outlining the object and stuff like that, basically, where there's a lot of math in that I'm not going even to try to get into. But more or less, this is what is happening under the hood. And after you train your image, you get to evaluate it by some specific, let's say, marks and features. And we are also going to do this. So we are going to do all of those three things on an example of a classificator that will recognize cats from dogs, basically.
This is where all those dogs, those pictures of dogs come in.
That's correct. Yeah. I already have downloaded it just to make sure that I'm not going to waste any time for that.
Right.
But yeah, I said that we are going to build a classificator. So I just wanted to explain what classification and detection is. So I have taken these two photos of my cars, you know, in front of my house, whatever. The first one, as you can see, is Ferrari. The second one is Aston Martin, obviously. And what actually the problem of classification kind of answers is only the information, what do you see in this photograph? We usually assume that there is only one kind of this object, and there is only single object, and you do not care about the location, whether it's in the left corner on the or the top right corner or wherever else. You just basically show the object and you want the answer. So this is going to be our case. It's kind of the simplest one when it comes to definitely gathering the data in Azure, because you basically need to gather a lot of pictures of one type of object than of the other type of object. And how it goes is basically you upload all the images to the cloud. You just tell Custom Vision what the object is. So in our example, it's going to be dog. And in the second upload, it's going to
okay.
be cat.
So now let's jump into the live demo from our guest, Mikolaj, as he shows us Custom Vision.
There are a lot of links, so sorry for that.
No, this is great. But yeah, all the resources.
But yeah, this is the data set that we are going to use today. So if you want to, for example, recreate it on your own, then later you can use it. I'm not going to download it now because I have already done so. I can show you my desktop maybe. And yeah, these are the images we have downloaded right now. So you can see the pet images, right? So if I will go into this, what it actually gives you is one folder of cats and one folder of dogs. And what I have done here, I actually extracted 50 images from each one. So from 0 to 49, it gives us 50 images. You can see like here, 50 images. And why I did that is because I do not want to be bothered with uploading all of the images, because this data set is not, well, that small. If we will go to the main folder, you can see here at the bottom that there is, I don't know if it cuts or if it's visible, but there are 12,500 images, actually 501. And actually, I must say that some of those cats are kind of creepy looking, but yeah, these are just the images we will have
my
to
cat's right, like, she's right here sleeping, though. Gonna...
Yeah, quickly you can make a photo and we can try our model later, yeah.
Yeah,
you have cats and here you have dogs. Dogs are even having more flashy eyes and stuff. So yeah, these images are great. I think even browsing them gives me chills at my back. But yeah,
we can do this all day.
I prefer this one actually. Yeah. Okay. But enough of this nonsense. So yeah, I extracted the 50 images from each, and I have done so just to upload those 50 images. And we are going to train our model only on this small sample, also to show that it's super intuitive and it's kind of intelligent to learn on 50 images.
Yeah.
And the rest of the images we are going to use, so we are not going to use the first 50, but we are going to use any other image just to kind of test our model when we are finished.
How many are there in that data set that they gave you?
Yes, I've said there are like 12,501.
12,000 in that whole directory? Wow.
12,000, yeah.
Okay, cool. Yeah, it's really impressive that it doesn't need, well, I mean, of course, you know, cats and dogs aren't the most difficult thing to parse through.
Yeah.
But it is still impressive how little it needs to learn this stuff.
Yeah, it does, yeah. Probably if we were to upload even more images, it's never a bad idea. If the data is kind of, you know, different from each other, then it's definitely good to do so. But yeah, how are we doing with the time, by the way?
We are pretty good. We're coming right up on an hour that we've been going. So we got about 30 minutes or so before we all start wrapping up.
Okay. All right. Yeah, that's all right.
We're good. Mm-hmm.
So let's just proceed to our Custom Vision portal, which I have shown before, and I'm going to just sign in just to show you the process. So here I have my Student Ambassadors account to which I have the subscription attached, so I'm going to use this one. And as you can see, again, very nice looking dog. I have prepared one project kind of as my preparation for this session, just to make sure that, well, it is live demo, and if something will not work, I don't know, upload will not go through or something, we have this kind of as a backup. Mm-hmm. But we are going to go through everything from the beginning. So as you log in, you will probably see here a blank page. You are not going to see any other project. And you can just click create new project to do so. And bang, you are just now attacked with this huge form. But I'm sure that as we break it down into parts, it's going to come clear.
If you want to learn more about custom vision as well as cognitive services and our guest Mikolaj, take a look at the links here. Until next time, I'm Jason Hand, and this is All Around Azure.